To do great work, you have to have the courage to work in the shadows. Hey, it's Lucas Grobot, and you're listening to Weaver and Loom. Welcome to episode 97 of Weaver and Loom. Weaver and Loom is a solo segment of Own the Future, a podcast that's made for and by changemakers. And by definition, by the fact that you are listening to the show, it means that you are a changemaker. And we're right now in the middle of a series on what it means to be a changemaker and what it means to be an absolute nobody. I believe that if we want to be great in this world, if we want to do great work and see the change, that vision that we have for our life, in order to see it, we must be people who are courageous enough to live as absolute nobodies, to serve even when we're not getting the credit and we're not getting the recognition. Yesterday, we talked about how we were born for greatness. And this is really the foundation of so much. We need to know, without a shadow of a doubt, that we were born for greatness, that we were born to do great things, and we were born great. And from that place of knowing who we are, knowing our identity, which we're going to talk about in a few episodes from now, actually episode 100, we'll be talking about identity. But from this place of knowing that we are great comes vision for our life, comes a direction that we're going, comes the courage and the boldness to step out and say, actually, I have a dream, I have a vision, and I'm going to risk everything in order to accomplish that, because I know that I was placed here with a purpose, and that purpose is great, it's grand, and it's amazing. No matter what anyone says, you were born for greatness. So that vision for our life, it has to be big. It has to be bigger than probably the small dreams that you might have right now. When I go over my dreams and my vision for my life, often I'm like, that's probably not big enough. I'm probably selling myself short of my potential and of the things that I really should be pushing towards. Why? Often because I'm afraid. Another thing is, you need to write that vision down, that what were you born for, that greatness that's inside of you. You need to write it down, and you need to write it and make it plain and clear that you can execute it every day, so that you know the direction that you're going every day. Because if you don't, you're going to get swept up into one of two problems, which you're going to be talking about in the next two episodes. But today, we're talking about, in order to do that 30,000 foot work, the vision, in order to achieve the vision, the greatness that we're called to, we have to be willing to work in the shadows. Now, notice I didn't say necessarily live in the shadows or hide in the shadows, but we have to be willing to do the work in the shadows. And this is what it means to have the courage to become an absolute nobody. We've talked about before the book Franny and Zoe by J.D. Salinger. It's a novella, which is just a short novel. And in the story, Franny, she's in college, she's in theater school, and she's competing for the lead role in a play. And she comes and visits her brother Zoe, and she says to him, it's so sickening, everyone trying to be someone, everyone trying to showboat and one-off and become somebody. And then she says, oh, I wish that I had the courage to be an absolute nobody. She says this meaning that she is like them. She has centered her life and is pandering for the likes, the praise, the approval of other people, wanting to be seen, wanting to be in the limelight. And she's so sickened by the fact that she doesn't have the courage to be okay with not being seen. And that is where the real work is done. It's when we are not seen, when we are working in the shadows. Because here's the thing, if we want to achieve our really great 30,000 foot dreams and visions, what do we have to do? We have to work and we have to serve. Even if the vision is become a multi-gajillion billionaire, That means we're having to serve millions of people, for millions of people to give us finances one way or another. We have to provide some sort of product or some sort of service. And the higher that we go, the closer that we get into fulfilling the vision for our life, the vision that we've written down, the purpose that we were placed on this earth to fulfill, the closer we get to that, there's a converse relation between the closer we get to fulfilling our vision and purpose, our greatness is conversely related to how low we go and how much we're willing to work in the dirt and in the shadows. Now, this is typically coined as servant leadership, or this understanding that when you get a promotion, it's actually a demotion. When you get promoted to manager, it actually means you're now working and serving all those people under you. And the CEO of companies is actually not only serving all of the employees in their company, but also serving all of their clients. We are all, as we grow in our leadership, we need to grow in our service to other people, in caring for other people, and figuring out how we can empower and position and equip other people for success. If it's our product or our service, it's saying, how can our product and our service better equip our client for success? This is what leadership is. So if we want to achieve that 30,000 foot goal, we have to have the courage to become absolute nobodies. Now, what it also means to be an absolute nobody is willing to work in spite of getting recognition. Now, when we think of greatness, oftentimes our mind will go to famous people or movie stars, but really they are in the limelight. But when it comes to financial gain, there are many other people in the movie industry in Hollywood that are making a lot more money. Some of the richest people are CEOs or number two or number three in companies that you probably don't even know they exist or know their name, but they have worked in the shadows, provided incredible amount of service, and because of that, they're reaping incredible financial benefits. Now, there's not necessarily an equation saying that if you have more money, then you're a greater person or you have more value. That's not what I'm saying, but I'm drawing the parallel between the fact that it's when we work in the shadows, often it's there that we're adding real value. There we're finding real purpose. There we're actually doing work that matters, because it's in that place that we're serving other people who are achieving the vision and the goals and the dreams that we have for our life. It's through serving them and empowering them, when we don't get recognition, that actually moves us closer to our goal. So my closing thought is this: we need to have the courage to be absolute nobody. And that means serving our dream, our vision, our goals, our cause, for the betterment of others, even when we don't receive recognition, even when we don't receive credit. If we want to achieve our vision and the great things, we have to be able to work in the shadows. Now, the next 2 days, episode 98 and episode 99, we are going to be discussing two enemies of achieving greatness and of working in the shadows. And so be listening for those two things as we are on this series of what does it mean to be a change maker? What does it mean to be great? And how do we do that? What is the mindset that we need to have in order to fulfill the vision that we have set out for our life? Thank you for listening to this episode. I'm always honored that I get to spend this time with you. Please, if you have a friend, and I know that you do, tell them about the podcast. If you are enjoying it, I'm sure that they are going to enjoy it and get value out of this podcast as well. And another reminder, my book, Anchor the Discipline to Stop Drifting, is on Amazon. The link is in the show notes. Please go and get it, as it will help you anchor your life and find that vision and find that direction for where you want to go with your life and achieve it. That's all for today's episode. I'm Lucas Scrobot. You are a change maker, and this is where destiny is woven.